Now I request Professor Ravi on academic industry interaction.
So we had a bigger group, 17 people whose names you can see. I'm immensely thankful to all of them for joining us and very passionately talking, so much that we never realized when the time for tea was up. And but many of the themes are reflecting from Amresh and Professor Baldev. Also, I am sure it will reflect in Professor P.V.M. Rao's thing also. Education, for example, was a recurring theme. So what we did was to divide into six groups of points, and all of them are kind of actionable points. So in each of these, we have some insights and some actionable points. So those six are basically redefining the goals. Attitudes was major thing. Education, which is across all of them, came up, and I'll show you some points in that. And enablers, scaling up as well as enablers. So the first one, goals, we kind of redefined that whatever we do, we cannot lose sight of the overall goal, which is essentially that inclusive manufacturing, the way, whatever we define. I know Amresh has been trying to define, but I think it is such a complex thing that just to put it in the right perspective will take us a few days. So all some of the brackets which you see are the points which came up from yesterday, picked and chose, other points which came up in the discussions in today's breakout session. So one of the main thing was that we need, academics do not have any mechanism or incentive or expectation of working with industry. They're expected to teach, at the most do research. But how do you incentivize them? How do you get them to do that? A few passionate people can make a difference, but you're losing out on 90% of faculty or scientists who can make a difference. So we need mechanisms to do that. And to do that, we need to have various things, which is essentially bring academia industry together, and we'll see in some other slides also. Like for example, networks and communication. And we need some champions who know the two sides, and they are the ones who trigger, they become catalysts for bringing it together. This was a huge thing. In fact, we spent, I think, almost 30% time on that attitude. If we can, in fact, perhaps this is the cornerstone of the whole thing. If we can change attitude, I think a lot of things will already automatically fall into place. So for example, our notion, like yesterday they said, throwing money like water is no longer true. Water is actually more expensive than perhaps money, okay? And not only minimizing waste in manufacturing, but whatever waste is produced, to reuse that to create, you know, products and wealth and things like that. Two points which came yesterday, which also was appreciated, that scientists should appreciate the value being added by industry and also by people who have made it big in industry but do not necessarily have a so-called formal education. So that appreciation is one first step. So scientists have to lower their egos and appreciate other people. One other point was that, like, doctors are asked to work in field. Can we ask engineers to work in field? Because I'm aware that many education institutes, including IITs, have stopped works visits because of sheer numbers involved. But maybe it's a time to bring it back and give the exposure to students to with industry. And in industry here, I'm using a loose way. Industry means anything which is real life. One other point which came is that most academics who teach manufacturing haven't manufactured anything in their life. So how can you expect them to teach? So how do we have mechanisms by which, and some mechanisms were there in USA, and then they are there in Germany. And those who don't know manufacturing can't teach manufacturing. But we need to bring in some kind of a policies to make sure that only those who know manufacturing can teach manufacturing. Otherwise, imagine a heart surgeon teaching heart surgery without having done ever a surgery, right? I mean, we are supposed to be professional education. The CSR point came up, it was discussed in various dimensions. On one hand, the CSR is about industry looking only as visibility. But also, if you sensitize them properly, then CSR can be leveraged very beautifully to get them into inclusive manufacturing and so on. And perception needs to change. The rural and urban academics and industry, they are not from Mars and Venus kind of a thing. I need a better word for this. But we need to change the perception that we need to understand each other. So attitude was a huge thing that was discussed. Now, some mechanisms for engagement were discussed. For example, both approaches, forward approach and reverse approaches, were discussed. Forward is where academics build some technology and then give it to industry. And the reverse one, where you look at application first and then do research necessary for that. But by and large, the consensus is that the second approach is the right approach. You must engage with the end users, if not in the first step, at least second step, and then do research. Okay? So that is perhaps better. And academics have to engage in multiple ways. We're talking about involve various stakeholders, learn from them. Academics have to stay in the rural areas and so on, or with the people to learn from them, appreciate them. that mentioned to you, internships, bring it back. So I'm actually eating into a lot of education-related things which people are present, but this was one of the very passionate discussions about how do you bring the interests of students and academia into. But we'd also appreciate academics, that's not the job. Our job is to teach. But then I'm questioning that what we're teaching is irrelevant. So that also has to be. And we should not also demonize industry all the time. I mean, industry is doing a job. Their job is to make profit. So this was my understanding of this session is that these questions are quite complex. And we cannot just do a half an hour brainstorming and say, we have some panacea or solutions for that. We have to mull over it. There are many, many facets of that. But it's a starting point to keep the engagement up. Three more slides. One was scaling up was the important point. But one theme was unless we say that scaling up is not necessarily always good, especially when it's leading to unsustainable mechanisms. Very clearly that government projects can be used to do an initial experiment, but not continue to fund it forever. So you need to build in mechanisms for sustainability. This is a point which is well known, but what people lose sight is that when you do a pilot project, we are doing only pilot project. We are not thinking all the way about how it is going to scale up. So that thought process has to be incorporated as you start a government project. That was one point. And need for systematic approaches and mechanisms was very important. Now last two, one is technology enablers. They are kind of known devils. So judicious automation, and when you do automation, we cannot stop automation from taking, it's like a demon, it's like letting a demon out of the bag, so it'll take its own shape. You cannot stop people being displaced. So plan for automation displacing people and training them and reorienting them has to be planned as you think about that. And the usual suspects in technology, you can see that, including village manufacturing centers, micro factories. And not only leverage technology, but also best practices from great places like ISRO and nuclear, which have done very well, and integrated platforms. And but one point, and which I think was reflecting an ambitious thing, enhance the design and technology development capability of the end users. We can't ask them to be dependent on us all the time. Enable them to create their own technology, their own processes, products, and so on. I think that was very valuable last point. Last slide is about other enablers, and there's a big basket list of various things. So training, educating rural people about how to do business. Some practices are very valuable. Enabling them and also making them appreciate the value of patenting, which came from Premnath yesterday and also today justified more. And other things like certification. Because Vishwanatham's thing about how do you ensure the trustability of the ingredients in food chain, could be applied to any other chains, okay? And also technology foresighting. I think we are not very very good at, we do have technology documents coming up once in a while, but I think still maybe it has to be better in terms of the impact of technology on the sustainability and social aspects has not perhaps been that well thought about, and that has to be one point which has to come up and look 30 years later and so on. And Professor Karnakan mentioned that, for example, IITs have a very nice system of only teaching 8 months in a year. So 4 months students are actually free in which we can engage them in internship, and they do internships. But many other engineering colleges, and that's 95% of engineering colleges, they are engaged in courses almost the whole year, N plus exams. So I think freeing them up as per IIT model, at least that's one good thing among many things in IIT model, it can be mapped into that. So these are some of the points. We tried to prioritize, but we ran out of time. So perhaps we will still continue on the email and try to look at some priority items, which are also somewhat novel. What will Modi ji look, you know, as an interesting idea, things like that. So we will continue on the deliberations. But thank you to my team, and thank you to all for listening.